Let's start the show.
I don't give a shit if I'm blind, I want to be drunk.
I'm gonna do this question this time.
How do you keep your glasses from sliding?
Big face.
I had a big face.
Just these particular, like, they don't really slide. Okay. I don't know why. I mean, I've had ones, though, that would slide all the time, and then I would have to be like...
I saw this guy at the grocery store, he bent over and they fell off, and I was like, except I'm a nervous wreck and I always catch them because I'm so tense.
Yeah,
when my face gets like oily, it's like worse. It's like...
Look, I was looking online and this guy was like, you can put nerd wax. We're talking about glasses slipping.
Do your glasses ever slip?
No. She was good on the pop-ups.
Oh, yeah, yours aren't sliding around.
But yeah, this guy online was recommending nerd wax. I was like, yeah, that's what I want, is just a bunch of like oily wax all over my nose all day.
That's a great idea. Really help your confidence.
Have you seen Cats?
Yes, actually I haven't seen the movie.
Oh, no.
Cats, the musical, like the real musical, like 6 times.
They're of equal quality. They're both just as
My mom was like a musical person, and she took me to see Cats a bunch of times.
Oh.
Yeah, I saw it as a kid, too. It has a special place in my heart. I know all the songs.
Me, too! Yeah, I know. And I always cry. You know, there's like the moments I know I'm going to cry. Yeah.
Have you seen it as an adult?
No.
I wonder how it would be different.
I recommend the movie. I've only seen the first 10 minutes of it because my friend saw the cockroaches and she got really mad and she forced us to turn it off because she hates cockroaches.
Oh my gosh. I've been wanting to see it forever, but a lot of friends are like, like, don't want to go. And then
still have all the songs and even the new one.
Yeah. No buttholes, though.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
What?
They censored out the cat buttholes.
Yeah.
We like to cover 3 topics in this show. Race, religion, and politics. Which one would you like to start with? Okay, let's move on to something more serious. What's your preferred corn preparation? On the cob, cut off onto the plate, canned...
Cream.
I definitely prefer on the cob, 100%. It's like that, like typewriter, you know, get the vibe.
Get so messy.
Yes, exactly. Plus you have that like juicy, full-on phallic experience. Maybe you guys know this already, but that part of the corn is actually the female aspect of the flower, like. So, like, if you're gonna look at a corn plant, the little wispy stuff at the top is the male aspect of the corn. So it's this phallic female symbol.
Huh.
So this powerful flower that's like super phallic. So I actually love corn.
I know what we're having for dinner.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is a good follow-up. This is stupid. This is very stupid.
You wrote it!
I know, but that's why it's so bad.
I like stupid.
On that note, what bluegrass instrument are you?
Woo! I am definitely a banjo. For sure. I feel like I've got that, like, you know, the round, can't see it right now, but I get the like, wide hips, round tummy that can be drum part. And you can also like really reverberate. It's like such a electric instrument in its own way without even being electrified. It just sounds so loud. Just even the acoustic version is like louder than life. And it also has like a ping, ping, ping. It's kind of like an over hyper imagination come to life, which I think would be me.
I'd be that jug with the X.
Oh, yeah.
I feel like I'd be a. Are fiddles in bluegrass?
Oh, yeah. Hell yeah. That's like the
high pitch.
But it has to be golden and the devil is fighting his way.
High pitch screeching. Yeah.
A piece of grass?
What color?
An apple grass?
Yeah, that.
Yeah.
You can make
it go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But,
Am I allowed to ask questions too?
Yeah.
No. What's the weirdest thing you've ever seen come out of a vagina?
Oh, okay. That's a good one. Well, actually, this is like sort of, I don't like saying.
I can give you all of those.
What's that?
I would say, let's see. the Witch House video, it's like a seance video. I had like all these worms coming out of a vagina of a sex doll. So, I mean, that's kind of for real the weirdest thing I've ever seen. And that's to be like focusing on me. But I don't
watch
a lot of like extreme porn or anything. So, I guess like the weirdest thing maybe just came out of my imagination. I did edit porn for a year, so I was like kind of mining for the weird stuff. Not very sexy.
So
not like cats.
You were editing bad
right,
porn.
Exactly. Where I'm like, trying to like almost like categorize porn into different genres.
Mm.
It was almost like a research project.
What's the best method for organizing the categories of porn? Like the Dewey Decimal System or alphabetical?
I mean, I just have like a long list, like a kind of like list that was like sexy long. Like.
I like that all of this is written on a gigantic penis.
Yeah, that's
so true. I didn't think of it that way. Yeah, I was like, ooh, this scroll. I kept type taping more and more, so I got longer.
But this kind of plays into, so what's so glorious about glory holes?
Ooh. So I really like the secret aspect of it, you know, that like, ooh, who's behind there? It's so mysterious, and it could be a complete stranger who's either like a truck driver or a, like a who knows.
Like that's your mystery.
That's
a truck driver.
It represents a world of possibility.
Exactly.
Very nice.
Yeah, it was beautiful.
Thank you.
Nick's a poet. This is a kid show, so we can really say whatever we
want. Okay, cool.
I guess I'll change it up a little. Practical effects or CGI?
I feel like this still fits into porn.
Okay.
Trulee, there you are. Thank you for coming back. Oh, bye, Nick.
Bye, Nick.
Bye.
And let's take a commercial break.
Thank you.
Yeah, movie is a funny word. I really like it. It kind of sounds like the bounce movie.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It's got that slow-mo
yeah.
Baywatch,
yeah,
too.
That's what it's called.
Oh,
yeah, I was like, what is that term?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm into boobies, you might have noticed.
Just a little bit.
We did our research.
Should we play a game?
Yay!
Okay, we have a game.
Oh shit, where's the mouse?
So, we're gonna play a game called How Much Does a Witch House Go For These Days?
Oh!
In honor of your mocha acquisition. So in this Google Doc, is a series of photos of witch houses, and we want you to guess the value of the witch house.
Oh my gosh, okay, I'm totally bad about this, but okay. Yeah, I see Massachusetts is first.
Okay, yeah, so this cute little creepy witch house in Massachusetts.
Wow, Massachusetts, I assume the prices are way lower than California, but I don't totally know. But this is a very special place. I'm gonna say it's 400,000.
I like that you slammed Massachusetts because they deserve it.
Okay.
Their stupid housing market.
Next we have I think this house might be a little famous, but the Beverly Hills, California witch house.
Oh my gosh.
And we just have an estimated price because it's definitely not for sale.
Right, oh my gosh. Yeah, that's like such a special place. I don't know. I think that one would be like 3 million.
All right. And now we have somewhere in the UK. I cannot read that from here.
How cutie.
Yeah, this is a cute little cottage witch house that would lure unsuspecting children into it.
Right. Ooh, maybe they have candy.
Yeah.
From The Hobbit?
Okay. This one in euros because it's, you know, the dollars and euros are fluctuating. But
they would be on the pound now, right? Has Brexit happened?
Right, that's true. The pound, yeah.
I don't mean to be poundantic.
All right, and last one.
Well, this one's got a little suburban look to it.
Yeah, it's got a little suburban, little stone, little pointy. It's kind of like a mixture of different.
This witch works in an office in like a 9-to-5.
And then goes home to their cauldron.
Yeah.
It's on the cul-de-sac.
It is on a lake.
Oh, lakefront property.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's helpful because that makes a big difference where it is.
Yeah.
So it'd probably be kind of expensive, but not everyone wants to live in a weird thing like that. So.
Or in Wisconsin.
Ooh.
True. Yeah.
Yeah, real shithole.
Oh, it is on the lake, though. So it's probably more like 350.
Okay.
I wonder if it has like the properties of like the lake house, the movie The Lake House.
If it comes with Keanu.
That's gonna raise the price significantly. I did wanna ask, why is art so easy?
I actually do think art is easy. For me it's like the easiest thing ever. Like it's like natural and so fun, you know? So, like, the rest of life can be like, climbing up the mountain, but I feel like art can be, like, pretty easy, actually. Like, I want to draw a squeal, and like, cool, looks good, you know? Art however you want to, and have fun with it. I also feel like there's degrees of ambition or whatever, but, like, seriously, if you just want to be like, I made art. Like, that's also valid. Every step of the way to me is very interesting. And I learn all the time. So it's like a rewarding process. It's not just like doing something that just drains you. It's like refeeds you, like, oh, I learned something cool. Oh, yeah, this is cool. I'm working with interesting people.
Thank you.
You have to really embody the challenge of being an artist, like, as though you're, like, fighting a worthwhile battle or something. Like, I got the paper mache ready, You have to embrace the change and the spontaneity of the process.
Oh, do you or Willie have anything coming up this summer that you want to tell our dozens of fans about?
Willie has a special event next week. I have a solo museum show in Berlin right now, which I'm really excited, just opened. And it's a combination of paintings and videos and installations. Including some old master paintings by people like Duchamp.
Oh,
so I'm really excited about that. So it's like my new weird, like, kind of, you know, conceptual and maybe sassy work in relationship to these old masters, which I'm excited about. I also have, and I'm doing a international studio visit. So I'm going to be, like, touring everybody from Germany and London, whoever tunes in, on my studio, so you can see more of my experience for that. And that's Gary Human 8th and 19th, so just, like, next week. And then I also have work in a few shows coming up.
Ooh,
one of the very small flyers, which is kind of like a cool, smart LA gallery.
You gotta go see Cats again.
I'm totally going.
Can you sing Oklahoma? All of it.
I can sing part of it. What, do you want me to sing it right now?
Yes, please.
Okay. All right, I've got to get in the zone first.
We didn't do our vocal warm-ups.
Yeah.
Okay, so, I mean, like, when you live in Oklahoma, you can basically just, like, blast into it, because, like, somebody will say, Oklahoma, and you'll suddenly just be like, Oklahoma, where the wind comes sweeping down the ranks on the plains, and the waving wheat sure smells sweet, while the something, something, etc. That's where you always start to trail off, because you then get to the part where you're like, plenty of corn, plenty of wheat, plenty of something, something and sweet, but I don't remember that.
I want to make it to the second, the spelling part, the spelling test of the song.
Yeah, I got really nervous when I got to that point. I was like, oh no, I don't know how to spell it properly.
Yeah, you can't mumble through that. That
no.
would be really apparent.
No.
But this does build on the Pieta. And can you cry on cue? I know this is great for comedy, so.
I can cry on cue, but it takes me like a little while to like get there. I actually think I'm a little bit like cried out right now, or I would like try to like, I would try to induce it right now, because I'm sure that would be so entertaining. I mean, like the reason why I'm kind of like cried out is because I wound up having a fight with my neighbors, and they like fucking like called me a dyke in the middle of the street. Which was really messed up, because I don't think that anybody has ever, like, called me a dyke before, and so it's just, like, sad now to think, like, you know, well, every time that, like, I walk by their house, I know that they're, like,
oh, yeah,
thinking dyke,
put that pride flag up, just lean into that shit and antagonize the fuck out of them.
Yeah, definitely. Actually, here, I'm gonna, you know. Oh. decided, like, you know, from now on, if, like, if people are going to call me a dyke, then I'm just going to really lean into it. I'm just going to be the biggest dyke that you can imagine.
Do you enjoy a nice day at the beach?
Yes.
Okay.
Very much so.
And in a related question, don't you think the census is a waste of time and taxpayer money?
Yes and no. Only because it does give us numbers that end up resulting in major policy shifts and also federal funding and state funding.
But isn't it fun to lie to the census worker when they come to your house?
It is fun. It is very fun.
So what classes do you teach at UNLV?
So I mostly teach classes in illustration. So they're elective classes. So illustration here is pretty broad as to encompass everything that deals with visual narrative. But, you know, specializing in comics, characters, a little bit of sculpture too. So it kind of runs a big range. But then I also teach the more required courses for the graphic design major, so Design Studio 2. But
very
every
serious.
Now and then I get to experiment with like printmaking hybrid.
Well, I have a question for you, and then I have a follow up. Who is your favorite student?
Whoa! Who's my favorite student? I don't think I could say so. It would be too much of a favoritism. I get in trouble. I mean, can I talk about characteristics of favorite students?
Oh, this would help prospective students get some insight.
Yes.
What are you looking for?
Yeah, this is how you
What are you looking for in a student?
What are the measurements?
I think the people who are willing to take a lot of risks in the classroom and also push back against me a little bit. I know that sometimes I space out, and it's really helpful when a student is like, today is not Tuesday.
What I'm hearing is parachute into your interview and then yell at Tiffany.
Yeah, sounds good.
Can you rank the different art media?
The worst one, which I also really enjoy, but sometimes it's hit or miss, is performance.
I feel like that really speaks to how you feel about this interview and how it's going. Is there anything you have coming up that you'd like to promote?
Things coming up. I have a show coming up at Left of Center Gallery here in North Las Vegas. So I'm grinding on that. This is not sponsored, but this is going to be the next couple of days. Yay, automotive paint. And
we'll blur that out.
Yeah, and then elsewhere, you can find me on the beach for the summer and back home in the Bay Area at some point. And then taking care of my new pet snake.
Okay, we need to talk about that snake.
What kind of snake is it?
It's a baby ball python. So it's very small right now. Sorry, I'm not at home. Otherwise, I would take him out. But
that's for the follow-up interview.
Yeah, this will be my friend for a while. Maybe I'll just be one of those people that carries my snake around in public.
What would you say is the best part about UNLV?
Oh, the diversity, and also it's, for me, in my experience, UNLV is the safest place that I can be myself, because the town that I'm living, it's called Henderson, but we're calling Hendertucky. So sometimes I feel like, wow, UNLV is really really, like, I can feel really safe there. I can be, you know, so that is one of the coolest thing. And then also very cool people there, teachers and students, So I guess being an artist, I kind of like to be in that kind of environment, not so many rules or judgments, good questions.
Another really important great question. What is the best Destiny's Child song?
I know Beyonce is there.
Well, you used one of them in your work, so I hope you know that one.
Say my name. Is that?
Yes, I was gonna ask you to sing it for us, but I don't know
how
that.
Around the time I was studying American culture, so I think that is a big part of me, like listening all the songs, and I was like, I really like that song, but yeah.
Can you rank from best to worst the different art media, painting, sculpture, performance?
Okay. The best to the worst, the best, that's a good question,
let's go to the worst. What do you mean?
The worst, performance.
Oh, fuck.
You know, the reason why I rate the performance the worst is because I see, you know, if you hate somebody, it's because you hate your something about you, and then that person has that, and then you don't want to see that side of it, so you hate that person. It's like a performance, and I had that relationship.
I can't relate. I'm perfect. I don't have any bad qualities.
It's true.
Do you have anything coming up that you want to promote on the show or your students?
Today's my opening of my solo exhibition.
Give a little bump. Where is it?
It's at Enterprise Las Vegas Library space. So it's, I cannot really explain the location of it. But you guys can probably like Google it and find out where it is.
We'll leave that up to the audience.
Yay!
Fantastic.
Congratulations.
Put that on your CV.
Yeah.
Lives in the sewer.